next we go to the third factor, the stage and the number of lactation. When the mother cow give birth to a calf, then she give one lactation. Okay, we start to take milk from her, and the lactation lasts for around 10 months, and that's called one lactation. If she give the second calf, birth to the second calf, then she give the second lactation, the third lactation, and so on. And during this 10-month lactation, we can divide into different stages, the beginning stage, the middle stage, and the end stage. And among these stages, milk composition and the yield of milk that the mother cow produces is also not the same, depending on the need of the baby, need of the cow. That milk composition and yield changes over time. I think we discussed this a little bit last time already. Now, the gestation period of cow is 9 months. The gestation period of human is 9 months and 10 days. This is also the reason why people convince that dairy cow is suitable for human, because the gestation period of cows and human is quite the same, 9 months and 9 months, 10 days. Just one of the reason. Okay. And the lactation period lasts for 10 months. During this period of time, dairy cows produces around 8 tons of milk, and then the calf only needs 1 ton, and the rest, of course, is for human. The peak in milk production is at the third lactation. It means at the third time that the mother cow gives birth, she would give the highest volume of milk. At the first calf, she is still very young. She is not adapted to giving milk yet. So at the third one, she is more mature, like more adapted to giving birth and to giving milk. But when she gives more and more and more calves, like at the 7, at the 8, at the 9 calves, then she become already old and she would not produce a lot of milk anymore. Normally, people stop the lactation at around 5 to 7, means that after giving birth to 5 to 7 calves, the mother cow is not like maintained for giving milk anymore. And normally, they will send her to slaughterhouse for meat. If you already know slaughterhouse, it's where people kill the animals for meat. For human, okay, and then after giving birth to 7 calves, then she is already old, and then she cannot give a lot of milk anymore, or it's become more difficult for her to get pregnant. Then what would happen then? For example, now in Vietnam, if now a mother dairy cow give birth, if the calf is female or if the calf is a male, okay, what would happen? For example, if the calf is a female, they can keep her and raise her to become a mother cow to give milk. If the calf is a male, what would happen? Normally, they just keep him for around 3 to 4 months, and then they would send him to slaughterhouse. And to make in Vietnam, it's called bê thui, okay? And then slaughterhouse to make veal. Veal is a meat from calf, from young cow. So why they don't keep the male dairy cows to raise them up to a larger body weight? Because it's normally not very economical to do that. These cows are suitable for making milk. Not very economical for making meat. You can raise them to go larger, to become bigger body, but however, it's not economical. They can eat a lot, or they can live long time before they can transfer into meat. Then it's not economical to do that. And then if the calf is a female, then she can be maintained in the farm, and to then be with the farmer, we raise her up to make a mother dairy cow to give milk. And then what is her destiny? And then if we look at this table, you will see. Now, at the 0 month, the calf is born. This is female calf. Okay. And then when she is at 15 months, she, that time is called a heifer. Heifer là con bò tơ đó. And then at that time, the heifer is inseminated for the first time. Inseminated means to make pregnant. I don't know if she wants to be pregnant or she doesn't want to be pregnant, but normally at 15 months, she will be inseminated. And then the gestation period is 9 months. You already know. After 9 months, she will give the birth to the first calf. The first baby. And then that time, we will start the milking cycle. 3 months after giving birth to the first calf, she will be inseminated for the second time. Only 3 months after giving birth to the first calf, the mother cow is inseminated again. And then 10 months from the first birth to the calf, this is a lactation. You see 10 months lactation? 10 months that the time to take in milk from her, and we go to a short period we call drying off. In this period, exactly, we stop taking milk. We stop taking milk from the dairy cow. It's just only 2 months after that, the mother cow will give the birth to the second half. We just stop taking milk for 2 months, so the mother cow has some time to recover her body, recover her health. She becomes strong again, healthy again, before she give birth to the second calf, and then we start the second milking cycle. And all this will just repeat for about 5 to 7 times, and then the mother cow become old. It's not economical to give milk anymore, and then people will send her to slaughterhouse for meat. So like whole her life is dedicated to serve human. I don't know if this good or not good, it depends on you. I don't know if the cow are happy or not happy. Maybe they are happy because they can serve human. Because maybe they determine their life is to serve humans. Now, we also discussing the effect of stage and the number of lactation. Milk of the first several days is called colostrum. This is a term. It's colostrum in Vietnamese means sữa non. Sữa của những ngày đầu á. Yeah. In Vietnamese means sữa non is somehow related to milk. The term is also used as term milk. However, in English, you see colostrum, this is very much different term compared to milk. Why? Because milk for the first several days is very much different from normal milk. In composition, it's very much different. It contains more salt, more protein, but mainly serum proteins, mainly serum protein, the protein which are easy for digestion. The protein which have protection role are actually immunity protein to provide the immunity to the young baby. And then colostrum has less lactose compared to normal milk because it already contain more salt, so it should contain less lactose to maintain the osmotic pressure. This is also belong to homeostasis mechanism that we already said to maintain a certain level of osmotic pressure for the health of the baby. And then after that, after the first 3 days, now we have normal milk. In normal milk, further changes would occur. There is a decrement, I mean the reduction in protein content, casein, serum protein acids, and so on. And at the end of lactation, then the increase occur. There are the changes over time. Okay, now the question is why milk composition is changing over lactation? The first answer could be due to the natural need of the baby. Okay, like I don't know if I explained already, but the first several days, the baby would need protection, would need to build the immunity for her body. Okay, because when a baby is born, the environment is completely changed. When she is still inside the mother body, then she is protected very well. But now she is outside of the world, a lot of factors, a lot of exposure to many environmental factors. So she need to build her immunity, and milk of the first several days is very important to do this. But then after that, now the baby now need more nutrient, more energy to grow, then the milk composition also change to meet that demand, and then so on. And then at the end of lactation, the baby normally only needs some supplement, because that time she can eat solid feed from outside. Okay, the pH values also changes over the lactation. pH of the first period is 6.6, and then to 6.7, and then to 6.9 at the end. So milk at the end of lactation is somehow has higher pH value, is more basic, okay, more alkaline. I mean, this is how this apply to human. Okay, so maybe in several years you will get married and you have baby, and according to our belief, maybe some old lady will tell you that the first milk should be thrown away because it's dirty. But actually, now you have to change your mind. The first milk that from you should be given to your baby, because it's very important. That's give her a lot of protection, a lot of component which is good for her health, right? Even nowadays, you know, colostrum, they already sell colostrum from cow in the market with a price several times higher than normal milk. It's very expensive, but not like colostrum 100%, not only part of it, but the price is already very high. And then later on, you will see that when the time you giving birth to your first baby in the hospital, you will see that in many conditions that infant cannot take milk from the mother directly, maybe because they are still weak, maybe due to some reason that the baby are separated from the mother. But remember, colostrum is very important for her. In case she cannot take this milk, you can take for yourself and put in a freezer, and then after several days she can take it, and you can give to her, because milk of the first several days is important and good for her, should give for her. Other if she cannot take it, then just give to another baby from your neighbor. Should not be thrown away because it's valuable. Okay, yes. And then what do we see here? The changes in milk throughout the lactation. Lactation lasts for 10 months, we already said 10 months. And during this period of time, as you see, the dry matter of milk increases for the first month, but then dropping down. The milk yield, the yield mean how much milk is a mother cow produces. The first month is increases, but after that is reduces time to time. And then we look at the right number of milking. Number of milking. Normally, one day people do two times of milking. So if you see at the fifth time of milking, means it's already the third day, right? The first day, the second day, the third day. Then after 3 days, milk composition changes a lot. Okay, and this period is called colostrum, and from here to here, normal milk. What do you see? In colostrum, in the first 3 days, whey protein is very high, and then lactose is a bit lower because mineral content is higher. We already said the fat content, the casein content is also a little bit higher, but especially whey protein, especially immunoglobulin. This is an immunity proteins. This is to provide the immunity to the baby. So in colostrum, it is very high. So this milk normally is sensitive to heat because whey protein is sensitive to heat. When you heat, the protein will denature. So if you take colostrum from cow and if you heat it, you see it will actually coagulate, form a gel. It's the same like when you boil an egg. When you boil an egg become firm. So when you boil colostrum, it become firm like a boiled egg, like a gel. It's not normal milk. But for normal milk, when you boil it, it's still liquid. But for the colostrum, you boil it, it's become like a boiled egg. See? Because it contains a lot of whey protein, which can be denatured by heating. And then the next factors is the age of the cow. Time to time, the dairy cow become older and older, and then this is somehow reduce the yield of lactation to produce less and less milk. And I already said as well, when the dairy cow become older, it's become more difficult for her to get pregnant as well. And each time she mix the insemination, then farmer have to wait for the next month, 1 month more to do the insemination again. And then like we raise her for 1 month without giving milk, that's quite costly for the farmers. Okay. So normally when the mother cow become old enough, then people will just send her to slaughterhouse for meat.